Engines armed. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All engines running. Launch commit. Liftoff. We have liftoff at 9:34 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. The tower is clear.
And we have a roll program. Roger. You have good thrust and off landing. Same Doro, roll complete. Roger. And we have a pitch program. Roger. Stand by for mode 1 Bravo. Mark 1 Bravo.
Roger, 1 Bravo.
Booster systems engineer reports to flight director that S1C stage looking good. Dynamics reports go for staging.
Which stage?
Roger. FTN Houston, you have good thrust on the S2. All five are good.
Okay. Okay, Bob, you can see we're up over one of the littoral rails now. You can see the rail cutting diagonally there from about 6 o'clock to 2 o'clock across the picture. And you can see some of the wrinkle ridges. In fact, here's a beautiful wrinkle ridge right below us right now.
Right, I believe you. I see it.
I'll pan up along the wrinkle ridge here so you can see. And they're a very, very distinctive thing. Now we're out over
20 at 1, 15 at 1, minus 1. Minus 1, 6% fuel. 10 feet, minus 1. 8 feet, minus 1. Contact. Man. Okay, Houston, the Falcon is on the plane at Hadley.
Roger, Roger, Falcon.
Dave, an extraordinary television picture here.
And Jim, I'm going to put a big circle around this glass ball so we don't mess it up. It's pretty neat. Do you want me to take it as a contingency sample? Yeah, I wish we had. We ought to document it. Once you see those things unlocked up there in the stowed position, it doesn't give you too good a feeling. Looks like she's coming down okay. Hey, can you pull down a little bit, Jim? Up. Okay, go ahead. No beads of glass in there in some places. Oh, I'm sorry, Jim. Got it. You know, when you lean over downhill, what happens? Get some more? Yeah, get some more. Okay, now let's get some typical soil a couple feet away, okay? And you know what we're going to do when we get through this thing, Joe? We're going to roll it over and we're going to sample the soil beneath it. I'll take it right out here by the Nomon. Yeah, good idea. Haven't been disturbed. Okay.
Attaboy, Dave, that might fill a square for the football size rock.
Can't get another one. Can't. Yeah, you can't see with my shadow there very good, can you? Okay. Data. Data, boy. Okay, hang on to this one for a second. There I go. Okay. 181.
Roger, 181, and we have a view of the rill that is absolutely unearthly.
And I'm moving over to connect the side cable to the control station.
Very fine.
I'll give you a demonstration here, Joe. Put the TV on this pallet here.
Roger,
and
right on.
Here it goes.
Dave,
Dave, this is Houston. We agree that if you've hit bottom there and think there's no way you'll go any deeper, just press on and put the probes in this hole.
Okay, Joe, I'll give it one more try here and see if I can get some more, but tell you one thing, the base at Hadley is firm.
Roger, so much for the Ferry Castle theory.
Yeah, oh, I'm afraid that's it. I hate to say that because it's working good.
Roger, Dave, there's a lot of information right there. Jim, this is Houston. The diverter valve is yours now.
Okay, thank you, Joe.
You had a good clean startup.
Okay, I'm on intermediate.
And Dave, you're about a minute from a flag on your water.
Okay, should I go to aux now?
When you get the tone.
Okay, then I'll do it once you close it up, and I'll put it right here. Dying to look at that big rock. Put this in your bag. Just right like you got it. Keep digging. Tip, you'll have to. That's right. Okay, I can see it. That's fine. Boy, when you put your scoop in, it smooths it out flat just like plaster.
I was gonna say like cement.
Yeah. I can't see any layering because the
scoop just.
Yeah.
It's all very similar in color.
Into whether. Nice and cohesive, it holds a straight wall very well. Very fine powder, just like graphite. Okay. Now why don't we call out a trench? Wouldn't that be nice if you could do that at Station 8?
Oh, I hope so.
Yeah, I hope so. Let me get this move to your left. And let me go over here. Go further, Jim.
Okay, troops, and we'll be asking for an SESC from the bottom of the trench when you get it built.
Okay. Oh, got a handle, buddy. Yep. Just get in front of me and get your hand. Okay, stand by.
Yeah, I think so.
Not that one. Oh, yeah. As I get down to the 12-inch layer, the surface is much harder to dig through.
We're
tilted backwards.
2, please.
Back up here so I can get all of that in there. TB?
Tell me when to slow down.
Okay, you're doing fine. Going. Okay, now, that's it. Now pull it once more time. Good, okay. Oh, shoot, I'm sorry. So much dirt on this thing. Okay, now, use it over. Okay. There you go. Good? Use it now, huh? Okay.
This is Houston.
Houston, go.
Roger, DR. We're thinking that that SRC is not closed very well. We're wondering if it'll go on the LEC properly.
Okay. Doesn't feel like you really need it. Sure doesn't, does it? Why don't we just leave it there? Okay, if we have marginal comm, I'll lower.
Yeah. Roger, and you're both loud and clear.
Hard rock, but it's covered with mines and talus. And we haven't seen to the bottom. I think we'll get a chance to look further down. Oh, hey.
Hang on.
Yeah. All right. Go. Pretty soft, but.
Okay, Davey, you might check the lens, and if it looks reasonably clean, see if you could get the bit of outcrop on the near side to the south.
The real. And I'm, I guess we're just about at the lip.
Amazing, huh?
I have a picture. Okay. How about a quick
single core here.
Yes, sir, or maybe even a double core. We think you can probably drive two of them.
Okay, I think we probably can too. I was just giving you a little bait there.
Roger, a piece of cake compared to that drill.
Even I can agree with that, Joe. Good. Good. Comprehensive sample. Now we need some soil. Three more smacks and you ought to have it all the way in. Hey, good. I'll give you a double core on that.
Okay.
Good show. Okay, I got the picture. Down, Dave.
Oh.
Got a good one.
I guess so.
A little bigger than 6 inches, but it was neat looking.
Well, that makes up for it.
How long, Jim?
What's a long laugh?
Yeah, a long laugh about centimeter.
Roger, Jim, we copy that. And as much as we hate to, we're going to have to get you aboard the rover heading back across the Mare towards the east, please.
Okay. 500 is 155.
Good show, Davey.
Either. Darn. Man, that's hot. I'll tell you what. It's riddle. Resetting the nav system. Okay, Dave, I'll get the gate for you to be ready to go.
I got it.
Okay, I think we have everything. All set, buddy.
Yeah.
Millimeter mag, Jim. One that didn't work. But it looks like it did. It's kind of cool, huh? Board stage, engine arm bath in. 99 Pro. Lift off, automatic. Taking about 306.
take a break.
Okay, Jim, I'm ready to bring the other one back.
Hey, Alan, looks like you're running fast up there. That's beautiful.
There was the mapping camera cassette.
Okay.
Slightly harder, but no problems are really expected. I would estimate that those parachutes are about 2 to 3, maybe 4 miles from the ship. There's very little wind out here, and those chutes are just gently lowering that command module down. The astronauts report that they're in good shape. And the recovery helicopter with those 3 Navy frogmen aboard now moving into position. What a beautiful sight. And there is impact, splashdown, and you can hear the cheering of the men on this ship. The 600 men aboard the USS Okinawa. It might have been a little bit of a hard landing, but it was a beautiful landing. And there you see the helicopter moving into position that will drop the frogmen into the water. That will start the recovery operations of the command module Endeavor and its 3 astronauts coming back from their longest and most challenging trip to the moon. Swim helicopter now hovering about 15 feet above the Pacific, 330 miles north of Honolulu. And there go the first 2 Navy swimmers into the water. Command Ranger isn't really bobbing around too much. The sea is relatively calm. The first job of those exploration, the underwater demolition team 11 from Coronado, California. What the swimmers are doing is they completely remove the collar bag and then hook part of it on. We're about 3.5 miles from the command module now, observing the flotation collar being attached to it. And there you see the Russian trawler, which is about 5 miles from the command module, steaming in the direction of splashdown. We just wonder how close it'll be. During the simulated exercises back in mid-July, the trawler came to about 1,000 feet. Not because the sea is rough, it's rather calm today. It's just the downdraft and spray from the helicopter rotors whipping things up. And there's the first astronaut out on the raft. We can't tell who he is, but you saw him with his multi-purpose, long-sleeve, white outer garment. Easy to detect. We don't know what his reaction was as he looked down into the bottom of that raft and saw that mural drawn by the Navy Park team. And here comes the second astronaut. Again, difficult to identify them. Another little round of applause as the second astronaut raised on that short trip out of the Pacific, about 330 miles north of Honolulu, back to the recovery helicopter that will bring him back to the Okinawa in just a few minutes. To space, he's more excited than anyone else aboard the ship. Here comes him, and here come the astronauts.
May we pray? Our Father, we are grateful for the success of this mission, for the work accomplished by astronauts Scott, Irwin, and Wharton. As we learn of your universe, may we also learn of your purpose for mankind to live in peace. Amen.
Thank you, General McKay. And thank you, crew of the Okinawa. The crew of the Endeavor is glad to be aboard. We appreciate the fine pickup, and it's been my experience the Navy always makes a fine pickup, whether we land 6 miles from the carrier or 6,000. They're always there right on the spot, and we certainly appreciate it. It's great to be back. We had a great time on the trip. I think we accomplished a lot. We had a lot of support from a lot of people, and I'd just like to say that we appreciate every bit of it, and we could not have done the mission. We couldn't have gone one step without the support of the many, many thousands of people involved. Thank you very much.
It's not that I'm shaky, it's just that I don't have my sea legs yet, you lucky stiffs. You've been out here for a while. We've just finished probably the most fantastic 12 days I've ever had in my life. And I guess only one thing surpasses the excitement and the intense feeling I had on the flight. And that was sort of the feeling I had when I saw you all today. It sure is nice to be back, and it sure is good to see you all. Thanks a bunch for the pickup.
This is a very proud moment for me. Proud to be part of this great team that could send us to the moon and bring us back. The recovery was just excellent. Of course, I feel very happy to be aboard a more seaworthy craft than we just got off of. Also, I'd like to say that I hope all of you all around the world enjoyed the
They can see. And they're a very, very distinctive thing. Now we're out over
20 at 1. 15 at 1. Minus 1. Minus 1. 6% fuel. 10 feet minus 1. 8 feet minus 1. Contact.
Okay, Houston, the Falcon is on the plane at Hadley.
Roger, roger, Falcon.
Dave, an extraordinary television picture here.
Engines armed. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. All engines running. Launch commit. Liftoff. We have liftoff at 9:34 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. The tower is clear.
And we have a roll program.
Roger.
You have good thrust and off island.
Thanks, Toro. Roll complete.
Roger.
And we have a pitch program.
Roger, pitch. Stand by for mode 1 Bravo. Mark 1 Bravo.
Roger, 1 Bravo.
Booster systems engineer reports to flight director that S1C stage looking good.
Okay, Bob, you can see we're up over one of the littoral rills now. You can see the rill cutting diagonally there from about 6 o'clock to 2 o'clock across the picture. And you can see some of the wrinkle ridges. In fact, here's a beautiful wrinkle ridge right below us right now.
Rex, I believe you. I see it.
I'll pan up along the wrinkle ridge here.
Each of the S1Cs.
Roger.
Of the 5 S1C engines gulping 3 tons of fuel per second.
Inboard?
Roger, inboard.
Flight Dynamics reports go for staging.
Houston, you have good thrust on the S2. All five are good.
Okay.